There are those that just want to be left alone, and those that just won't leave them alone. Which one are you? The Ernest Hancock Show.
It ain't so groovy when you're screaming in the night. Let me out of this cheap B-movie. Headlong down the highway, and you're rushing headlong out of control, and you think you're so strong, but there ain't no stopping, and you can't stop rocking, and there's nothing you can do about it.
Yeah, there he is. You can call Gary Franchi. Say, Gary, what's up, man? You know, come, you'll save my butt. I need to be on your TV program because, you know, damn. Because if I'm not, I have absolutely no support anywhere else in La System. Because there is no support for individuals that are willing to go up against the man. You know, the support structure only comes from the people. And if there is any kind of, all of a sudden, some county prosecutor decide they're going to advocate on your behalf, it was after you made it onto Reality Report. Give us some of the coverage that you guys have done in the past that have had a positive impact on the people that were victimized.
Goodness. Well, there was a story. Oh, man. We've done, gosh. Well, here's a story. The FBI recently came out with the Unabomber as the target or the culprit for the Tylenol murders that took place in the Chicago area about almost 30 years ago. And I was approached by a woman whose mother was poisoned by the cyanide that was in those capsules. And she tipped me off with some information about it. And that day, it was like literally a couple days later is when the FBI came out and said, oh, we're investigating the Unabomber. So we put out a big story about that. Got some really good coverage. We were, you know, first kid on the block with the story, and got just a lot of coverage for this book that's going to come out and blow the lid off of the entire official version of Big Pharma's, basically Johnson & Johnson's story about the Tylenol murders.
Tell us about the ability of having video in such a high quality format that you guys do. I mean, we do video, we could do more and so on, but I'm spread kind of thin, you know, and you're more focused on the video aspect of the presentation of this information. And I'm wondering how much of a crew that requires. I mean, it's a quality product, and what's involved in putting on the show like you guys do?
Well, it starts with a tip. And a lot of times we get a lot of people sending us stories, but we just do not have the resources to address every single thing that comes across our desk. I wish we did. But our crew is literally in-house about 2 days a week. And then we have two interns that just started working for us. One just graduated from Western Illinois University. Another one is interning from the Illinois Center for Broadcasting. So we picked up a couple interns. You know, they're hungry. They want to start putting out content. So I tell them, okay, look, here's a story. Investigate. You know, and I help them mold the story and bring it together and give them tips and how to, you know, just put it together. And then, of course, we have our editors and we have our special effects guys that assist in the final, you know, the polish of the whole production.
Well, tell me about your interns. I when I first started doing radio and so on, I did have interns from Walter Cronkite School of Journalism out of ASU, Arizona State University, and I've gone through a couple. And to me, I got the impression that, of course, they're looking for employment. They want to, you know, build up their resume and so on. And they went on to work for different think tanks. Like one young woman, she went on to work for the Goldwater Institute, and and I encouraged her and helped and kind of, you know, whatever. But the impression that I got was that they're wanting to climb the corporate ladder of the system as opposed to opposing it. Now, that was, of course, you know, 5, 6, 7 years ago, and I'm wondering what their mentality is now. Are they seeking you out going, hey, man, we want to go save the planet? What's their mindset?
Well, I've had a couple interns that have come in here, and they're like, oh, they saw, you know, the Don't Tread on Me poster, or they saw, you know, a website up that was familiar to them, or they hear us talk about, you know, InfoWars or Freedom's Phoenix, and they say, holy cow, you know these guys? And we're like, yeah. And so we're actually picking up people who are already hip to what's going on, so we really don't have much of an educational learning curve to get them involved. So they're already hip, and they want to help, and they want to investigate. Unfortunately, there have been instances where these, you know, they're young kids, and they're not, you know, they may not have reliable transportation and blah, blah, blah. So, you know, they don't always hang around as long as we'd like them to. But, you know, there's others that want to go out and do greater things. And I'm just here to try to help them get a foothold in media production. And hopefully the content that they're going to be producing for me gives them some greater perspective on the world.
You know, one thing that we haven't seen from you that I kind of would, you know, hope that we get more of is movies from you. I know you work with, you know, other people and doing production and so on, but I would think just your story would be worth a video.
Well, you mean a story about me? A movie about
yeah,
me?
Yeah, no, about the Reality Report and RTR and where you guys started and from, you know, Freedom to Fascism and Aaron Russo and the evolution of the new media coming. I mean, I'm going, crap, man, this is inspirational to people that are just becoming aware of what's going on and how to communicate with people. You know, this is, wow. I mean, you know, like dovetails in with our e-zine, you know, our doing our magazine thing, which I, thanks for participating in that. Oh, what'd you think of that, by the way?
I love it. I love it. I think it's definitely a great tool. And I think that it has a viral nature that can reach a lot of people.
You know, and that's one thing that you guys offer is, I think you're far more inspirational than I think you realize if you would show them the back end, how this is done. Because a lot of people, it's a big giant hurdle to get over to get to where they can communicate as well as you do. They just need to know what to do. You know,
I've written my story, so to speak, and from my perspective and how I met Russo and when I started doing Lone Lantern stuff in 2005. And, you know, I've got a whole long form, you know, dialogue of how I've come to where I am today. I think it would make a kind of a nice little how to behind the scenes story.
I think so. I'll do it.
You know, I'm so caught. I would love to have someone come over here and do that, or me to produce it. But I'm so caught up in just trying to sustain our efforts and stab off all these attacks that are coming to us in this country and preserve our freedoms. That while I think that my story is important, I think that, you know, my fight and helping people fight for freedom is just more important right now. If somebody wants to come along and invest the time and the money and to do that, you know, I'll help them. But at this time, it's like, look, we got to fight to save this country.
You know, I believe this is part of it. When they had For Liberty, the documentary on the Ron Paul Levolution, I was very impressed with what they were able to come up with. And if they did the same type of thing, that was not so much focused on Dr. Paul or even the Levolution, it's the people of it. The people that mm-hmm. were really making this, and they got a little bit of that. I mean, they got, you know, everybody got, you know, you and I were in there a little bit, but you know, the thing is that I see the empowerment of the individual's ability to communicate as the threat. See, the reason, you know, a lot of people don't really understand why I wanted to do the digital magazine thing. And they're going, God, you already got, you know, the radio and video and you do the website, and you got the same information. Yeah, what the, and I go, and I saw what was available. It's this. They are going, they, them, those. The guys won't leave us alone. They want to control the dissemination of information. What's the story, top story today? They have that iPhones can be shut off at concerts so they can't videotape. Well, let me tell you, if they can shut off an iPhone, they, them, those, the cops aren't going to need a law. They're just going to turn off everybody's cell phone and any crime scene. They're going
exactly.
to be have the capacity. Oh, this isn't later. This isn't science fiction. This is science right now. So I'm going, God, you guys don't get it, man. You need to be able to be like the 60s and 70s where they're passing out pamphlets and flyers, you know, newspapers, printed material where nobody can censor it. It goes out. Well, what's the electronic example of that? PDF, enhanced PDF files for digital tablets for them to be,
you know,
able to.
It's wild you bring that up, because last night I was watching on History Channel. They were doing like the top 100 gadgets that changed the world. And they showed the audio cassette, and they showed how, well, we can get back to that.
No, it's the end of the show. Quick, man. You got 30 seconds.
Hey, well, just go to our site, join the revolution, rcr.org, and plug in and catch up with me there.
Hey, Gary, thanks for coming on, man. Yeah, the future, we're going to talk some more. Gary and I, we'll get together. We'll do a longer segment. I had short time today because I wanted to do the Alex Jones thing, but I'm telling you, the future is going to center around people exactly like Gary Franchi. Gary Franchi, realityreport.tv and rtr.org. Join the revolution at rtr.org. We'll see you tomorrow here on the radio. Uncovering the secrets and exposing the lies. That's what readers of freedomsphoenix.com get every day. Readers of freedomsphoenix.com are constantly provided the information that detail the real news between the lines of propaganda about government policies and the true relationship we all have with coercive governments. Learn the true condition of our economy, innovations and technological breakthroughs in energy, health, computer science, and space travel. Learn the truth well before it's admitted to in the lamestream media, the media that is so last century. Corporate media has evolved into nothing more than distributors of government propaganda, but we now have a fantastic alternative. FreedomsPhoenix.com provides constant news updates on the issues that affect our lives in the most important ways. Our liberty and our property are under constant attack, and FreedomsPhoenix.com provides the understanding behind the propaganda while encouraging the participation of our readers. Join us at FreedomsPhoenix.com. That's Freedoms with an S, Phoenix.com. FreedomsPhoenix.com, where the revolution between the ears has already matured.